Well, that's very nice of you to say.
Oh, really?
So, yeah.
I think it's a very.
How long is this gonna take? The rest of the day? Longer?
If it was my life in danger, David, I'd be glad of the assurance.
Yes, I get it. I screwed up, but having her face hang there, it's not exactly helping.
I expect not. Did you get a last name? Just Holly, then. And you brought her here to what? Show off?
I didn't know that she was going...
This will go a lot quicker if you just answer my questions straight, David.
Well, you know exactly why I brought her to the office. And it's not like it ended the way that I expected.
What did she tell you?
Her name was Holly. She liked my tie.
No alarm bells at that? And you mentioned you work perfection.
She asked about perfection.
And you said you were the head technical honcho and that you could hook her up with a tour of the office. Show her the multi-million pound research facilities and let her have a play with the commercially sensitive computer equipment. Something like that?
Something like that.
Is that how you usually pick up women? By offering them a free makeover?
I'm not perfect, but with my help, the right girl can be.
I am simply trying to ascertain what she got. Why are perfections so upset about this particular loss?
Okay. The world is augmented. In our brain.
Nanobots. I'm aware of this, David.
Yes, nanobots. But have you any idea what they actually do, you see? To most people, they just take it for granted. But look, prefrontal cortex, temporal lobe, optic nerve. Visual data comes in from the eye, the retina. But with nanobots, we can hijack that flow before that data reaches the brain. These screens, they're a delusion, a shared hallucination. My brain shapes an image, here a screen, and shares it with other bots in the vicinity. In this case, with the bots in your brain. Essentially, the visual data that you are receiving has been hacked. Now, as you can imagine, the applications for the cosmetics industry are revolutionary. The nanobots can be made to augment anything. Improvement to your face, change of color, absolutely no physical makeup necessary. Well, the effect is somewhat limited.
What is that?
That is the future. How we lose the limits.
That's what she took?
That's what she stole. It's a prototype. It puts out a signal that creates an utterly lifelike augmentation, tricking the brain of anyone nearby into believing that effectively the wearer is someone else. It's light years ahead of its time. I mean, that little beauty allows the wearer to become whomever they want, you know, to anyone, to everyone, and appear, even feel, utterly real. But, of course, there are flaws.
Flaws?
It borrows a bit of the user's brain to process the illusion. It puts a kind of strain on anyone who's wearing it. It can be unpleasant. We haven't found anyone who can wear it for more than a quarter of an hour. Any longer than that, and their brain turns to soup. This conversation is to remain within the walls of perfection, of course.
So you're saying it's impossible for someone to use it?
No, I'm saying that we haven't yet found the subject who can.
What are the chances Holly could handle it?
Small. Very small.
She did get into the heart of perfection by lying about your tie.
But I mean, she wouldn't understand it anyway, what it is.
So who else knows about this apart from me?
Just my team. Dr. Vargas, Dr. Marquez, and Terry Cryer. But that's all.
I'll need to speak with them.
They'll be at home.
That won't be a problem. I must say I'm quite impressed. The things you can do with technology. What was her name?
But I can look it up for you.
You don't know. What about her name?
But it's not.
Or hers.
I'm sorry, I don't know.
Why not? Well,
I suppose I haven't quite gotten used to it yet, but still, thanks to you, I understand a little better what this thing actually is. It gives you a hell of a headache. But, you know, if it'll help. Put a stop to all of this, I'll work on getting the hang of it.
Holly, please.
I've had this thing on for 3 hours. Are you impressed? It's been fun playing with you again, but I've got 3 more appointments to get to, so...
You're not thinking straight. Listen to me. Look at what you can do. It's incredible. I mean, it doesn't matter what you've done. You know, we can work that out, but you're actually wearing it and using it.
All that matters is the end result, yeah? It's typical. Yeah, 2 wrongs don't make a right. Blah, blah, I get it. Even in the beauty industry, killing is an ugly business. But then again, I don't have to be the one to do it.
Someone else can.
Subscribe to Dust for new sci-fi every week.